Oh, hi there. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing fine. This is one of the most important topic, which is data cleaning in Python Pandas. So one of the important problem when you are doing machine learning or any kind of data analysis is basically data cleaning. So the most important part is data cleaning. So what do you mean by data cleaning? Maybe you have zero values, maybe you have none values, maybe you have NA, or how do you handle all of these? So how do I fill, so first of all, we'll learn how to remove all these values using drop, and also we will try to detect various NA values which your is null won't detect. So we will learn all of that. Once we will learn all of that, then after that we will see ffill, bfill, so forward fill, back fill. Then we're gonna learn interpolation, how do we manipulate data. So we will learn all of that in this tutorial of data cleaning with Python and Pandas. So if you have any questions, make sure to post your question in the comments, and I would be very happy to answer all of your questions. So let's not waste time and get back straight into coding. So join with me on the tutorial series right now. Welcome everyone to the video series, and in this video we will learn the art of data cleaning with Python and Pandas. So we will use a lot of methods to visualize the data, the data that is null data. We will try to fill the data using backfill, forward fill, interpolation and lot more. So we will learn a lot in this video, so let's get started straight into coding. So I have a CSV file for this example, which I am gonna be introducing you right now. So the name is data.csv. So now let's see. So first of all, we need NumPy, Pandas, Seaborn, and the OS library. So first of all, I'm just gonna see, make sure that the file is already there. So I'm gonna say list dirs. So these are the files here. You can see the CSV file. So let me try to read it. So I'm gonna say, now see the problem. So pd.readcsv. All right, so once that is done, I can say df to essentially show you what's there in the data set. So here you see we have NaN value. We have NaN value, right? Now we have NA value, N slash A value, and we have NA value, that is this. Now, if you check, now see this, what happens. Now this is the problem, which most of the people are not aware about. So if I say df.isNull, now see what happens. So essential is gonna give me this. So it says temperature has one none value. Now what about this, guys? See this, we have one NaN value. What about this? It did not count these value. So Pandas has not was not able to recognize these as none values. Now how do we handle this this situation? It's pretty important, right? Whenever you're doing any kind of analysis. So similarly here we have just one, so that's fine. So the way to tackle this problem in Pandas would be, so while reading the CSV, you should define, now this is the problem, right? So now let's say handling the problem. Oops, sorry for the spelling mistake. All right, so handling the problem. So now what we will do, guys, is basically create a list of missing value. So it can be NA, it can be NA, it can be np.nan, right? So these are essentially all the types of missing value that I am expecting right now. Right now, while reading the CSV file, let me just show you the art of doing this. So missing values. Now, if I say pd.readcsv, and if I pass in an argument known as na underscore value. So if you do shift tab, right? And if you essentially just scroll down till you see this function known as na underscore values. So it should be there in somewhere, na, here you see. So na underscore values, by default it's none. So we will do this. Let me just run this. So we are gonna say na underscore values, and we wanna supply our custom na values. So we will say missing value, right? So now if I run this, and if I say df dot, and if I say is null, right, and if I do sum, so here you see now we are able to recognize all the three NA values. So essentially this one, and this one. So this is very important. So you learn something new to tackle NA values. You are using these methods, right? Now, how can you check whether you have any empty values? So simple, we can say is null, and you can just calculate the sum on that. Another method you can do is df dot is, we can say is null, and we can say any. So this will basically check. So here you see we have true, that means we have some NA values, right? So now we can also visualize those NA values. So we can essentially plot the heat map. So I can say df dot is null, right? Essentially this is gonna give me my boolean values, and I'm gonna say false. So here you see I have this color indicates if it was totally black, that means the data set is perfect. But now right now, since we have in temperature, you can see we have three of them, so we have three none values. Similarly in the humidity we have one, so this shows that we have one NA value. So I can say not true. So here you can see essentially this is where we have the NA values, where it's also showing us. So this is a pretty good way to visualize your data set using pandas. Just give me one sec. So we learned about detecting the NA values, right? So this was the art of detecting the NA values. So let me just write step one. Detecting, DETEC, detecting NA, N/A, and NA values, right? We learned about this, right? Now we will learn how to remove these values. So all right, so we will learn how to remove all of these values. So essentially I want to show you the data frame, right? This is what we had. Now let me just quickly open my snippets, right? And hopefully if this makes sense to you, df dot, I'm gonna say drop, and if I say drop NA, right? So if I just do this, let's see what happens. So essentially if you observe all the NA values, even this one, now we are taking care of this one, and this one, all of these, we actually drop all of them, right? But let's say we don't want to do that, right? We only want to drop where the entire row is none. So simply we can say how equals to all. Now if we do that, so oops, drop NA, let me quickly open my snippets as well. So drop NA and how equals to all, right? So let me just copy a small piece of code to make this concept to explain it to you in an easy way and not in a complicated way, right? So essentially what I will do is I'm going to remove these, and let me just paste this data frame for now just for explanation. So if I say df dot 11, so we have this data frame, right? Since excuse me. So here you can see we have one none values here, and we have second none values here, right? Essentially just a small data set to demonstrate what's happening. So now in on this data set, if I say guys df dot drop NA, and let's run it and see what happens. So we will compare both of them. So we had this NA values, right? So it dropped that row completely. We had this one, so it also dropped that row. Oops, I have to say df 11, sorry, really sorry for that confusion. So essentially now if you observe, this entire row was dropped, and even this row, which has just one values, was dropped. But I don't want to do that. I want to say when there are all the rows are empty, then only do it. So if I essentially just say how equals to all, so now you can see here both the values are none, right? So it's removed, and here only one value is none, so it's not removed. So you can just specify how equals to none, right? So essentially I'm gonna keep this. Now let me show you the art of filling data. So this is a data set, right?
So the first method that I will show you guys would be filling it with all zeros and then manipulating it. Df.11 fill NA, and I want to fill with zero. So now let's observe what happens. So here you see we had NA and NA, so we have zeros and essentially zero over here as well. But when you're doing data analysis, this is not a good way to write zeros. We don't want to do that. We want some kind of method to, you know, get write some kind of data there. So let me show you a method of FF fill, that is forward fill and backward fill. So let me just quickly, for just 1 second, let me just go to my snippets, right? So I can show you that. So this is what it did, right? Now let me show you the df11 dot fill NA, right? And now if I run the method equals to FF forward fill, so observe what happens now. So but before that, wanna just print my data frame also, so we can compare both of them simultaneously. So let's observe what happened. So here we had nothing. So this one got copied here, right? So this one got copied here. This we have 22, so 22 got copied here, right? And similarly, we had nothing here. So the upper value is 2, so the 2 got copied here. What happens if we do the backward fill? So let me essentially demonstrate that as well. So I'm gonna say fill NA, and I can supply a method, and I can say backfill. So let's see what happens. So essentially these are my columns, right? Now this 3 would be copied here. This is backfill. Here you can see we had 2 here, so 2 is copied here, and essentially we had 22, so 22 got copied here. Here you can see this is not a good way, guys, to do this, but there is one more way, which is just called interpolation, right? We also want to do interpolation on the data set. So df.11, let me just print that. So I can say df.11 dot interpolate, right? If I say that, see what happens. Now let me explain you. So 3 plus 1 is 4, divided by 2 is 2, so we have 2. This is interpolation. 22 plus 2 is 24, divided by 2 is 12, so we have 12 here. So here you can see this is the art of interpolation, all right? So essentially we learned about that as well. Now essentially let's go to the original data frame, which had all the none values here, right? So you can use any of these methods to do your cleaning on your data set. So we learned how to do all of these, right? So let me just quickly just drop all of them. So df dot, or let's say df df underscore drop is equal to df dot drop NA, right? And just run it. So you can essentially see the output. So now you can see we have removed all the rows and column that was dropped, right? So as I said, it's not a good method to do this. If you want to do this, you can supply again how equals to all, so it will only remove the rows and column that has both the none values. So essentially here you can see this only had single none value, so it did not remove it. So this is what it did. So this was not removed. You will ask me, hey, why this was not removed? Because here we also have a value, unnamed zero. So if all of them were zero, then this would remove it. So we can just say df.na, or instead we can just use a method known as interpolation, right? So this is my data set, right? That is how it looked like. So I can say interpolate. And now if I print it, so we have values now. So that's it for this. One more thing that I forgot to mention is basically if you wanna substitute the values, right? So let me just show you what I mean by that. So here I have the data frame, right? So let me just print a small data frame. So I have a data frame, do you agree? Now instead of NA and I wanna substitute, let's say, or instead of 0 or 3, I wanna substitute 999999 or any values or anything, right? So the way you can do that is you can say df dot. First of all, you need a method known as fill NA, so which will take a dictionary, right? And I wanna fill all the temperature values where it says none, and I'm gonna make it due to some reason, I don't know. So here you can see wherever it was NA, now it's 8888. So you can also do this. Just wanted to show you. So thank you for watching, and hope you have enjoyed it. I also hope you have enjoyed this tutorial on data cleaning with pandas and Python. If you have any questions or if you have any suggestions, do let me know by doing that in the comment section below, and I would be very happy to answer all of that. So essentially, this was a new method that I taught you to visualize the data set which has null values using the heat map. So thank you for watching, and see you guys in the next video.